We're talking blockchain games, and Alien World is top of the charts when it comes to active users. But what does this mean for the future of Alien World's TLM tokens? In this video, I'm going to cover how to get started, what the project is, and also similar use cases. Don't miss out on this metaverse momentum. My name is Jessica, and if you are new here, please make sure to subscribe to not miss any more content like this. So, first of all, what is this game we're talking about? In Alien World's gameplay, the player will take on a mantle of a 2055 adventure. The goal is to go to distant worlds and extract Trilium. And everything in the metaverse is tokenized, and players will come across some pretty unusual things in the form of NFTs throughout their mining adventures. Now, we're going to talk about the token as well. The token Trilium, with a ticker symbol TLM, really incentivizes explorers to play the game, but it must be staked to participate in the governance. Planets within the metaverse are a decentralized autonomous organizations which receive daily Trilium through the smart contracts. Now, what's really interesting here is planets are independent and can offer their own games, user experiences, and NFTs. It does sound cool. Keep watching this deep dive, and we're going to cover how Alien World works. So every NFT in Alien Worlds has a specific purpose in the game. They're mining tools, for instance. They can help you improve your mining efficiency, and really useful avatars that may be helping you as an adventurous explorer really help to optimize gaining more tokens. Players can also mine more Trilium and find more NFTs as they upgrade their mining equipment. There are now 330 distinct NFTs available for the players to find and collect in the game. So if you think this sounds interesting to you so far, you're probably curious about the basic steps of playing Alien World game. Well, to start, you have to register and set up your character. And if you are an avid play-to-earn gamer, that's common knowledge for you. But there is one interesting element that you'll be able to select a planet or land to explore upon. You can change the planet later on in the game. After this, you'll be at your mining hub where you'll spend the next in-game decade of your life as an adventurer. If you do go onto the mining hub, you'll see the land you've been picked as well as a shovel, and you've already got it. This is where your mining process starts. Now, one of the reasons why this game might have got so popular is because land in the game holds huge value. Every one of the land plots is held by a different player. And a portion of the TLM a player mines directly goes straight through to the landowner. And then when you mine more, some landowners may actually encourage mining on their land on the Alien Worlds Discord channel. Now let's run through some of the use cases for Trilium and what they can be. You can use it to acquire NFTs, stake users by taking part in these planet governance activities. You can burn them when users shine NFTs. You can also be staked by councillors to participate as a potential candidate in planet DAOs. You can be required to take part in nebula events to gain these mythical and legendary items, and also used to take part in in-game quests. Now let's talk tokenomics. Total supply of Trilium is finite and set at 5 billion with an inflation of 9% per year. The price, well, Alien World's TLM is now trading at 29 cents at the time that I'm bringing you this video. So back to Alien World and why this project holds a lot of complexity. The Alien World token actually operates on three different blockchains: Ethereum, WAX, and Binance Smart Chain. All three are really popular blockchains in the crypto world. Ethereum and BSC really leading the front lines when it comes to these DeFi wallets. Low transaction costs, and near instant transfer fees. The Ethereum blockchain offers data coordination, rapid deployment, and high scalability, which is really interesting for the gaming space. The growing popularity of these blockchains may have had a significant effect on the price of Alien World's token. On the official Alien World website, it's ranked second in all dApps, passing Uniswap, and has over 150,000 active miners every hour. Now, as it continues to grow, is this NFT game, which potentially has uncapped potential, especially now that NFT markets surpassed $2.5 billion in 2021, going to go even further. With Axie Infinity hitting new all-time highs of more than $1 billion in sales so far, who knows? Many NFT games are on the market, however, not many have made the top rankings on DApp Radar. So is this the future of gaming, and is there more price potential? Well, I caught up with Stephen Arnold, CEO and creative director of Decimated, and here's what he had to say. So, Stephen, starting off, as someone that has been building these kind of games for years, how are you finding that investor demand has really changed in 2021?
I found that over the years, the investor sentiment has definitely changed, because we were working on our project way back in 2017, 2018, and we were going to a lot of blockchain conferences and video game conferences, and there was certainly not a lot of enthusiasm or demand for blockchain games. Yeah, I've definitely seen the industry kind of wake up to the possibility. Because years ago, I was always saying at these conferences that I believe that video games are the path to mass adoption of blockchain and cryptocurrency and digital scarcity NFTs. And a lot of people disagreed with me. They said that they believed that banking or logistics were like the path to mass adoption of blockchain. And I was like, those are like boring industries, you know, like video games are where it's at, you know. But It took people a few years to catch up, but I'm glad they finally did.
And do you think now we're going to see a really interesting conversion where we're going to see more typical big players like Nintendo and Sony move towards this blockchain tokenization NFT space, just because it is so profitable and it is so interactive for new users?
But Ubisoft and Electronic Arts and other big companies will still be able to make a profit. So I think that they're the first two big giant companies in the games industry that have woken up to the possibilities of NFT, blockchain, and the whole metaverse, where people are going to be living a whole life online. But I definitely think that over the next few years, and I know from my personal connections, that there's a lot of game studios that are interested in using blockchain in the future. So yeah, I think over the next few years, you're going to see a much greater merge between the traditional video game sector and the blockchain sector. But it's not going to be games that are built on blockchain like we have at the moment. It's going to be traditional games that utilize blockchain technology for the digital scarcity aspect, tradable NFTs on the secondary marketplace, and cryptocurrency inside the game.
And it is such an interesting time. Watch this space. Stephen, thank you. So now looking into the future of the tokens and also what to expect moving forward, it does really seem that the industry is moving at a complete headwind space. I want to hear from you guys your thoughts though on the future of NFTs, Alien World, and maybe some other play-to-earn games that you guys are enjoying playing. That's all from me. My name is Jessica. If you have not already, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you do have any more questions about the wild world of crypto, you can always ask Alex in the description box below.